Can you define what PINs are? So PIN stands for Physics Informed Neural Networks. Can you explain the fundamentals of PINs, and then we'll delve more into the details?
Yeah, so PINs are physics-informed neural networks, which means that they are neural networks that have essentially a regularization against physical equations, right? So physical equations are specified in terms of differential equations, right? So you have, for example, you know, Newton's laws of gravity. That's a differential equation, which is describing how the change in force is related to the mass of objects and their distances, right? So if you take any of these physical equations, they're pretty much all differential equations. And what the physics-informed neural network does is it says, well, we actually have to do two things, right? We have physical equations, which we kind of know are approximately true, and we have our data, which we know is like really true, but we might have too sparse of data, right? So what we want to do is we want to make it so that way we always try to match towards the data, but when we don't see data, it should be acting as something that matches our physical assumptions, right? And so the way that you do that, right, the physics-informed neural networks without data is kind of the first thing to think about, is that a physics-informed neural network without data is just a differential equation solver in the form of a neural network. And what you could do in that sense is you can say, if I'm supposed to be solving this equation such that, you know, like the Poisson's equation, that, you know, I have two derivatives in x equals one derivative in t, right? So this is that's the classic heat equation. What you can do is you can say my neural network is the solution to this equation. So my neural network is a function that takes in t and x and spits out a value that's supposed to be the solution to the equation. Mm-hmm. Now, how do I know whether it's actually the solution to the equation? Well, I can take one derivative in t, and I can take two derivatives in x, and I can subtract those two values. And if it's actually the solution to the PDE, it should be equal to zero, right? And so the loss function is to, you know, sample over space in different ways and then say, how close is this to actually zero? And you know, so then you know that your neural network coefficients are correct when you actually have the sum squared error of all these, you know, all these terms close to zero, right? Mm-hmm. So at its core, what the physics-informed neural network is trying to do is it's trying to add this information about partial differential equations and these physical laws to this training process of the neural network by giving it this loss term that is, here's how close you are to the physics that we know, right? You can then take that one step further and you say, well, now my loss has two terms, right? I have one term, which is how close am I to the data points? And I have a second term that is how close am I to the physical equation solution? And then this gives you a way to be able to, you know, essentially augment the physics with a little bit extra more and then hold something that is like the solution to the physical equation in a way that's like regularized by physics, but matches your data.